I can't even count the hundreds that have lived here over the years. The Tongan value and the way islanders work, it's the whole community. If I eat, you eat. If I make it, you make it. If I'm gonna come to New Zealand, you can come too. It's so beautiful, and it's actually kind of sad that we're starting to move away from that as we're here longer, as we're getting a bit more Western and modernized. Me and my cousins talk about it sometimes, especially after Tiwati's death, that it's like a rat race now, and you just look after your own little household. It would be really emotional for the whole family if we were to sell. Now that she's gone, a decision needs to be made over what will happen with the house. My grandmother's tiwati, Folau. She passed away in February this year, so I'm just here in her house in Herne Bay, Auckland, Tumuli suburb. I was born in 1985, and I lived here right up until I had my first baby. That was 2015. I think after that, I thought, I'm going to put my big girl pants on and I'll leave the Herne Bay house for a bit. And I came back and had my second child here. I think all up, I've lived here on and off for over 30 years. When they first moved in, it was actually like two flats. They obviously converted it to not two flats, but one big house. So the layout's like really weird because it hasn't changed. Like for how many years? Literally nothing's changed. This is a copy of the sale and purchase. So it's their title to the house when they bought it. Agreement made the 28th day of July, 1975. The purchase price is $21,500. Isn't that crazy?
It's crazy.
Their deposit would have been $1,000. Because you know, these days to get a house in Auckland, the deposit has to be like 20% 50. And it's... Not even 50. Like here, more. Your deposit for a house in Auckland is like 200K.
Yeah.
That was really huge that they could do that because they had really limited English and minimum wage and quite a few kids to look after and feed. Herne Bay and Ponsonby. In the 90s, it was still working class. And then over time, you honestly saw it morph into like real cookie cutter, really well-to-do people that drove Audis and Volkswagens, and the houses, they get done up, but they look exactly the same. They're all painted different shades of like beige or white, and they all have the same really well-trimmed hedges. Honestly, for people who have a lot of money, they must just get it all from the same brochure. I have no idea. I feel like with Loki taking a stand with our house that looks exactly the same. Our garden is the same garden that it was a long time ago. It's not one of those flash white fences that everyone has. It's like the same steel fence that Tongans put in. Yeah, I like that it looks the same. Would hate to just turn it into yet another Herne Bay villa. This house is so much more than nostalgia. It holds so much history and memories and pain and happiness, not just for us, but so many wider families. Honestly, this house means so much to so many different families around the world. My grandfather, Ekul, and my auntie, Lossie, they came first. Diweti stayed with the rest of the kids back in Tonga. After a bit of time, the rest of the family followed. And as was the case for Polynesians back then, everyone settled in Central.
It was our first house that my dad bought. We were very excited about it. We felt at home because most of the Polynesian lived in Ponsonby and Grey Lynn. Herne Bay wasn't so many. So when he walked down to Ponsonby, we were everywhere.
When my dad properly sat me down and told me about the history of this house, told me about the Dawn Raids, how there was a refuge basically for lots of different people to come in and out of.
There would have been a lot of overstayers here from Tonga, and as the police did, they would just rock up at the door before sunlight. Everyone knew to flee. You'd have some of the family running to the back and jumping the fence. There were a lot of family in the garage, but the police never looked there. Nobody actually, thankfully, got caught, as far as I know. My grandfather actually made the house bigger because, you know, he was a carpenter. And that's why that window...
That's new, eh?
Yeah, that's not one of the original windows. Yeah, because there was no window there.
The neighbour, he looks over the fence and he goes, oh, my gosh. So he rang up the city council, told on... There's a building going on over there. So,
of course,
City Council came, but because it was all, you know, it wasn't separated, so it was okay. Mm. They couldn't be bothered pursuing to pull it down
back
and
in
all
those
that
days,
stuff.
Then.
But it was back in the days.
The cost to maintain a place like this, especially if you've only got a couple people living here, is huge. Just looking around at the other houses on the same street, they're getting done up and redone up all the time. I can't even imagine the cost. Like, honestly, the cost will be in the hundreds of thousands. Stuarthi was always sitting here, where I'm sitting right now, in this specific place. But back then, she was busy. She was cleaning, cooking, gardening, doing something somewhere around the house. She loved that we were 2 seconds away from the Herne Bay Catholic Church. This was honestly one of Duethi's favourite places. I don't think they ever missed Mass. They laid their roots here as well, not just in that house, but here at this church. To this day, we all still come here. After that, all the women would help make Sunday lunch, and then at lunchtime, there would be like a banquet. There was always Duethi's big pots cooking something. I could always smell Tongan food. Nothing really flash but boiled meat. Doesn't sound flash, but so delicious because it would be like falling off the bone. There'd be chop suey. Of course, you had your taro and you had your green bananas cooked. There was raw fish back then because my grandfather liked raw fish. Different dishes that you could pick from. So that was every single Sunday without fail. Oh, look, you three. Yeah, look at that.
The exact same.
Look at these guys.
Our tongues,
yeah. Duethi and her granddaughters, Deja and Paulita. And then this one, obviously, is in their favourite place at the back of the lounge. Who's that baby?
Who's me? And I've got puffy eyes.
Yeah, you
know.
She's just saying that because she doesn't know how to make them.
No, I know how to make
them. She's
what?
The princess.
Princess. I am the princess.
Before and... during when she passed, I was running the Facebook, heaps of people sent like messages and did posts just thanking her. Many moons ago, a little girl loved the times of visiting your home. It was such a big deal. Growing up, Albany Road was pretty much Disneyland. Many moons later, the little girl grew up and finally understood the meanings to your akonaki, your teachings. Thank you, Duethi. So many unforgettable memories, raw, rich, and real teachings I'll never forget. Albany Road became my second home because of your love, one of the reasons I had a great childhood.
Butter girl. Man, these look good. Okay, they're hot, so watch out. Bro, I have had these for like years, like decades.
I know you are resting in our Heavenly Father's grace, Duethi. You served with your absolute all and left nothing behind. And also all of you grieving, such a great loss, but also honouring your memory.
Beautiful send-off for a beautiful queen. Thank you for providing to our massive family who came to NZ for a better living. Wouldn't be here without my siblings today if you didn't have a big heart.
Her and my grandfather worked so hard to settle here and build a foundation upon which their kids and us grandkids could thrive and prosper for, and it's showing. She was very proud of me to go to university, and I got an accounting degree. My cousin Joseph is a teacher. My cousin Luciane is abroad. She's in Vancouver, Canada, filming The Night Agent for Netflix. Those opportunities would not have been afforded had they not worked so hard to lay their roots here, and this house in Herne Bay is part of that. We're really lucky, and we're so blessed, and we know it. Like, we know it.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. We're good.
How are you?
I'm, like, totally out of the loop. What has it been like for you guys after her passing, being in the house? Has it been? I think that's the one thing that, like, oh gosh, when I go home, that's going to be weird for me. Like, coming home and being like, oh wait, she's not here.
When I got used to her being gone, I didn't like it. It's like I wanted to be sad, and I wanted to be depressed because I wasn't ready to be okay with it.
It was tough, like, because I knew, like, you know, this job's like 6 months, so I was like, okay, but yeah. Don't cry. It still feels the same, right? Like, it still smells the same. It looks the same.
Yeah.
So much of my imagination was in those walls. It was our childcare. It was our after-school care.
After the club care.
Yeah. Our parents were all working. And I think there was a time where, you know, Herne Bay started changing, and we went to school with all these rich Balinese, and you notice, like, the wealth difference, right? I'm so proud that we maintained so much of what it was originally, like, back in the 70s, because it has so much history. It's our connection to our culture. Like, we didn't grow up going to Tonga every year. We didn't grow up in Tonga. So it means everything to us, I think. And I think I'm really proud that it's the only house on the street that looks like this.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. It's like a mini protest, the house.
She is, like, the queen of Herne Bay. Like,
she is the queen of Herne Bay. We know it's going to go one day, right? So unless you want to come home with a easy 3 milli. 3 milli? You want to come with 3 milli and then it can be yours?
That's a dream.
We can manifest.
Oh my God, this is so difficult. Whoever needed a place to stay, or somebody who's lost who needed somewhere to go to, our house was an open house for everybody. They all found a refuge in this house. But like everything, we have to all move on and change and evolve.
You feel like, oh, the legacy is going. What a shame, all that's gone. It does feel like that when I think about it that way. When she passed, everything that she said started holding more weight on me, and I could understand it. When we're talking about what they did for family, it actually comes from the Tongan value of love, and she said this a lot. It's called fair offer o whānau. After over 40 years of being here in Herne Bay, no matter what happens to the house, that's my grandparents having provided